In this video, we're going to talk about 5 Photoshop tricks that you did not know. Probably. The first trick that I'm going to talk about deals with the advanced blending options in the layer style panel and how it works with blend modes. So I'm going to click on the brush tool. Then I'm going to make sure that white is my foreground color. I'm going to create a new layer and I'm simply going to paint with white. Then I'm going to change the blend mode to linear dodge. As you can see, there is no difference. And actually, I'll zoom in just so you get a closer look at what's going on. So we were in normal and we switch over to linear dodge. There is no difference. However, if you double click on the side of the layer to bring up the layer style window, you will see that we will make a change by using this blend mode and unchecking this box here. Under advanced blending options, if you uncheck transparency shapes layer, you will see that now the pixels blend differently. The edges around the area that I painted become hotter and brighter. So this technique is very useful for when you want to create specular highlights on metal, plastic, glass, on things like that, that you need something very bright and very hot. So just remember, all you have to do is uncheck this box and the pixels will blend differently. I'm going to press OK and I'm going to click on the move tool and I'm just going to move it around just a little bit so you can see how the edges become so much brighter. And the second trick I want to talk about is the precise flare, which is a tool that allows you to place the lens flare in precisely the right area that you want. So I want to place a lens flare here. This is a light source and I would like to make it seem as if this light were on. So we're going to use the lens flare filter for that. So I'm going to create a new layer. I'm going to fill it with black. I'm going to press Control Backspace, Command Backspace on the Mac, change the blend mode to screen, and it's going to look invisible because there is no bright pixels. And the screen blend mode only shows bright pixels. So I'm going to zoom into this area here. Now I'm going to bring up the info panel. And the info panel gives us some information, including the X and Y coordinates over canvas. So wherever we hover over, you'll see the coordinates. So we hover this area here, you'll see that it's 634 by 205. So I'm going to go into filter, render, lens flare, and anywhere on the preview window, I can hold Alt, Option on the Mac, and click, and that's going to bring up the precise flare center. Then I can enter those numbers into the X and Y coordinates. For X, we had 634, and for Y, we had 205. I'm going to enter those numbers and press OK, and notice that now I have the lens flare in that spot. Now I can adjust the brightness and adjust the type of lens flare. I'm going to leave it at 105mm prime, and then just adjust the brightness a little bit and push OK. Now we have the lens flare right on that spot. I'm going to zoom out, and now you'll see that we have our light right in the spot that we wanted to. And it's in its own layer, so that effect is, of course, non-destructive. The third trick I want to show you also has to do with filters. I'm going to create a new layer. Then I'm going to go into Filter, Render, Clouds. And we're going to get some clouds. This is probably not new to you, but what is new is what happens when you hold Alt, Option on the Mac, as you do that. So I'm going to go into Filter, Render, and now I'm holding the Alt key, Option on the Mac, and go into Clouds, and watch the difference. We get clouds with more contrast. So these are the regular clouds, and these are the clouds with more contrast. So if you want clouds with more contrast, all you have to do is hold Alt, Option on the Mac, as you apply the clouds filter. And the next trick you probably didn't know involves the black and white adjustment layer. So let me apply that. I'm going to create a new black and white adjustment layer. And of course, it's going to turn everything black and white. But if we change the blend mode to luminosity, it brings the color back. And we can use these sliders to control the luminosity of specific colors, for example, red. So maybe we can make the reds darker, or we can make the reds brighter. We can do the same thing with the blues and all the other colors controlled by these sliders. Another way in which you can use this technique is by using the mask. I'm going to click on the layer mask thumbnail and then hold Control Backspace, that's Command Backspace, to fill with the background color, which is black, and hides the effect. Then with a brush, I can paint with white and bring back that effect. So maybe I want more detail on the leaves, so I'll just paint with white on those leaves. And of course, this is a non-destructive effect, so I can come back into the adjustment layer and make further adjustments. And this is how you can control the luminance values of your image by using the black and white adjustment layer. And the fifth and final trick I'm going to show you is how to open up the same image on two windows so you can work on it with one image zoomed in really close to work on detail and with the other image zoomed out so you can see what the overall image is going to look like. So I have my file open, then I'm going to go into Window, Arrange, and at the very bottom choose New Window 4 and then the name of the file that you're working with. And that's going to create a second window with the same file. These are exactly the same file. It's not a duplicate, it's the same thing. So now I can go into Window, Arrange, and you can choose either two up horizontal or two up vertical. I'm going to choose two up vertical, and that's going to put them both side by side. So then I can click and pan on one image and zoom in to the area that I want to work on. And by the way, if you zoom in and both images zoom in, that's because you have the zoom all windows checkbox checked. So watch what happens. See how I'm zooming in on this one, but then this one also zooms in. That's because you have this checkbox checked. Or another way you can do the same thing is by holding shift and then zooming in. So if you just zoom in, nothing will happen. But if you hold the shift key and zoom in, then you'll do the same thing as having this checkbox check. You'll zoom in all windows. So I'm just going to zoom into the area that I want to work on, which is going to be this area here. And then on this second window, I'm just going to click on fit to screen so we can see the entire image, or at least that section that we're working on. Then I'm going to create a new layer and I'm going to click on the clone stamp tool. And I'm just going to extend these tiles up higher. That's all I'm going to do. So I'm just going to clone from this side. So I'm going to hold Alt Option on the Mac and then just start painting on my empty layer. Make sure that sample all layers is checked. And I'm just going to paint this until these blue tiles are extended higher. So maybe right about here. But notice that as I'm painting, the pixels are showing up on this side. I'm going to go up one more level just so you can see. Notice that as I'm painting, the pixels are appearing. That way I can see how things are looking way before I'm even finished with my clone. Now, if you see that some of the perspective is not working well, we can work with the Move tool. Press Control T, Command T on the Mac to transform and choose Distort. And watch what happens as I distort this image. I get to see the live preview from here so I can better match the perspective of these tiles as I'm making the adjustment. Once I'm done, I can just hit Enter. And obviously the effect is going to be applied on both sides. I know I made some mistakes here at the bottom, and I can either come back with the eraser tool and maybe erase this area or do any other number of adjustments. But in this tutorial, we're not really worried about that. I just wanted you to see the technique of using two windows for the same image and how it could be beneficial. Another thing that you can do is you can hold the spacebar, obviously, to pan. But if you hold the shift key, you can pan on both windows. So holding the shift key when panning and holding the shift key when zooming in or out will affect both windows that you're working with. Obviously, if I disable the layer, both windows reflect that change. I'm a little curious to know how many of these tricks you actually did know before watching this video. Just leave a comment down below telling me if you knew all of them, maybe none of them, or maybe just a few. Also, if you enjoyed this tutorial, please hit that like button and share it with a friend. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.